with a spa getaway without spending hundreds of dollars? Well, now you can, right at home. There's nothing better than spending some time in the spa and really relaxing. But the problem is that we don't always have the time or the money to do that. So the good news is that you can create some fabulous concoctions at home that will not only give you some relaxation, but you might even find that you like giving them to other people as well. All I want, Rachel, is a nice, relaxing bath. Well, you're in luck because we are going to make bath fizzies, and these are so much fun. You can use them in the tub or for an at-home manicure or pedicure, and you can customize them completely to your taste. To make bath fizzies at home, take a half a cup of citric acid, a cup of baking soda, and 3/4 cup of cornstarch, and mix those together in a bowl. Then run those through a sifter to really get the ingredients mixed. Then you're going to add about 1/4 cup of Epsom salts. Mix that in very well. Then take a 2-ounce spray bottle and fill it with water and about 6 drops of your favorite food coloring. Lightly spritz the mixture until it's damp enough to be packed together with your hands. Next, you're going to add your essential oils. You can use any essential oils you like, but we love peppermint.
Okay, so everything's mixed and it smells so good, Rachel.
I know, but this is the messy part.
Okay, what do we have to do?
Okay, so what you need to do is mix that with your hands and make sure that it's packable. So now it's time to put it into the ice cube tray.
Okay, and just take some like this?
Exactly.
Pour it in one of the cube trays?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
And then the most important part of this step is to make sure that you really pack it down. So you want to take your thumb and make sure that it's packed down and as smooth as possible on the top, because that'll make your product look even better.
Because we want it to be pretty, too.
That's right.
It might be homemade, but we want it to look professional.
That's right. After you fill the tray, let it sit overnight so they can dry, and then you just crack them out just like ice cubes.
Cool. Oh, look, they're so cute.
And this is really cool. Look at how they fizz.
And the best part is, it makes such a great gift. Is this for me, Rachel?
That is for you, Rebecca.
It totally wasn't, but I'm taking it anyway.
Whole lot of steps to make the bath fizzies, but it looks like you have something simple for our baths now.
We do. This is a really simple recipe that will give you a fabulous bath that will relax you.
Okay, Rachel, what is this thing?
This is called a tea ball. It's stainless steel, and you actually fill it with tea, and you can use it to brew tea to drink, but you can also use it in your bathtub.
So people can get this at their local kitchen store?
Exactly.
Okay, cool.
To make the tub tea, take the tea ball and set it in a little jar so that it won't topple over. Put a little bit of Epsom salts in, and then add your favorite scented potpourri. We chose vanilla. Next, drop some of your favorite essential oils right on top of that. We are using lavender.
So I just stick my tea ball in the tea bath.
That's exactly right. And the great thing about this is that it hardly took any time. And once you buy the $3 tea ball, it's only going to cost you about $1 for each bath.
Loving all these tea creations, and I love the way this can make your home smell like a spa.
It does, and it's also great for a bath. But the best part about this is that you can give it as a gift, and it will only cost you pennies. These tea bags are so easy to make. Get a package of empty tea bags that you can buy from a local tea store or online, and then just fill them with your favorite teas or combinations of different teas. To seal them, staple, and then toss in the water.
This was so easy. We stapled them together, and then look how cute. As a gift, you can give them away. I love this, Rachel. So nourishing scrubs cost so much money these days.
That's right, but we are going to make a fabulous one with roses and coconut oil that's going to cost you less than $10.
I'm excited. Let's get started right now. Take a jar and fill it 1/3 of the way with coconut oil. Next, add the petals from one rose. Then fill the rest of the jar with raw cane sugar.
On top of the cane sugar, add your jojoba oil. The jojoba oil will start to seep down and let the flowers distribute throughout the mixture. Once the oil settles a little bit, you can add a little bit more just to fill the jar.
Okay, that was so easy. No measuring involved. I love that.
I know, it's really easy. The last step is just to close the lid and be patient to let that oil seep down into the mixture.
Okay, and here's the finished product. Again, another great gift.
It's a great gift, but it's also great to keep at home. The last tip is just to make sure you stir it up before you use it.
And messiest for last. I love a great facial, but I just don't have the time for it.
That's true, and this is a really easy, quick way to get a great brightening, tightening facial because of the magic enzymes in this papaya. You only need 3 ingredients and a blender. 1 cup of diced up papaya, a teaspoon of honey, and a teaspoon of yogurt. Blend it together. Beautiful mask that will brighten and tighten your skin.
This looks like an awful lot for one person, Rachel.
Well, actually, it's enough for 2, but this one's just for you, Rebecca.
Yeah. Well, I'm gonna get sloppy with this glowing and brightening mask. How am I always the one that gets sloppy, right? In the meantime, you can go to lipwellnetwork.com for all of these recipes.
I'm gonna look fabulous after this, I hope.